You're Lafayette, right?
Yes. Who are you?
I'm Videl's mom. He wanted me to give you this note.
It's the fourth ingredient! What happened to Videl?
He has a high fever and can't move right now.
It's the terminal stage of the 12-year sickness.
It can't be!
All the other kids in town avoid Videl because they're scared of the disease. But you chose to be his friend. I want to thank you for that. Videl always perks up when he talks about you.
Miss Videl's mom, I know this is sudden, but can I borrow his book? If we can figure out the last ingredient, we can make medicine that'll cure him. I don't care what it takes. I'll decipher it myself and...
That sounds like it could be really dangerous. I can't let Videl's friends put themselves at risk like that. Besides, I've already lent the book to someone else. I've been prepared for this day ever since I learned he had the 12-year sickness. I'm sorry, Videl. I'm sorry I couldn't give you a healthy life.
What's the plan, Lafayette? Do you still intend to look for that last ingredient?
Why bother? Time's short and we're out of leads.
I know it's sad, but there's nothing we can do. Videl was fated for this end from the start.
Is there really nothing we can do?
Don't feel guilty. None of this is your fault. You've been a good friend to him. Besides, the Omega Elixir is a fool's errand anyway.
How could you say that?
Jeez, Velvet! Even I'd have tried to soften that one.
What's there to be gained from being less direct? Sure, it might hurt now. But in time, it will be just another memory. A sad memory you'll keep tucked away for when you need it.
How can you talk like that? Videl's still alive! And what about all of his research? The Omega Elixir is real! I'm sure of it! I'm not ready to give up!
Then stop talking about it and keep on looking.
You mean it?
Once you've lost him, it'll be too late. No matter how sorry you feel, no matter how deeply you regret, regrets don't change into memories. They hang over you like a living nightmare. But you haven't lost your friend yet, or your hope.
Yeah.
Then hold on to it as tightly as you can.
Okay, I'm going to find that fourth ingredient. Let's take another look at the clues in Videl's notes.
Is it true that more demons are appearing in other towns, and that some exorcists have suddenly lost their powers?
Yes, I'm afraid it is.
Is everything going to be all right?
Leave her alone, son. You're bothering the exorcist.
I just wanted to know how other places were doing.
In every city, the frequent demon attacks have endangered lives, caused chaos, and hindered travel and trade. Farms have been hit hard, and harvests are delayed. It's certain that there will be food shortages before long.
I thought as much. Well then, that settles it.
Settles what?
I'm going to plant an orchard and some vegetable fields. We've been lucky. We've been spared the worst of it. Also, the soil here is rich and suited for farming. I can't fight the demons, but I can help stabilize the food supply. I want to do what I can to help.
That's wonderful to hear. I'm rooting for you with all my heart.
You know, if you're starting a farm, you're going to need someone at your side.
Would you please stop bringing that up?
No. If you're serious about this, I want to do everything I can to find you a match. So on that note, how about it? He's a good boy. You don't have to marry him right away. You can take it slow.
Sorry, I'm kind of married to my work.
A shame. Well, what about you? The scary girl over there.
Who are you calling scary?
My apologies, miss.
Hey, aren't you forgetting someone?
No way! Love? Marriage? That's not important right now. Besides, I have a date with these saplings.
He chose a tree over me.
Mercio was attacked by the Lord of Calamity and the town was lost. They say a bizarrely dressed witch chased down the townspeople and devoured any she caught.
That must be the Lord of Calamity. She dressed as a cackling witch to toy and torment us humans. That monster!
They say she wore a black cloak, a big hat, and rode a broomstick. She jeered and jested at those she caught.
So, a demon impersonated a witch and hunted humans, huh?
What happened in Mercio really got twisted in the telling.
That's the grapevine for ya. But that aside, this is unforgivable. I'd never use a broom or wear a black cloak. It'd go against my superb fashion sense.
That place really was a prison island. Worse, I hear that's where the Lord of Calamity was born.
Where did you hear that?
From an exorcist who lost his Malak and caught the demon blight. He screamed it as he was killing his exorcist buddies. It happened in the forest. I managed to hide. I've never been so terrified in my life.
An exorcist turned into a demon.
He must have lost himself when he lost his Malak. Looks like we really did a number on the Abbey.
If that's true, then it means the Calamity was born right under the Abbey's nose, and they let her escape. How could they let that happen?
I don't know, but I guess it means the exorcists aren't perfect. I thought that if we followed the Shepherd, the Abbey would save us. But maybe that was just wishful thinking.
Finish this quickly.
Short dragon!
Exorcist. What's he doing here?
That's...
It's a world tree leaf.
We need that for the Omega Elixir.
You know of the Omega Elixir? You're no ordinary travelers.
I think you can tell that just by looking at us.
He seems wary of us. Should we take it by force?
No. We'd be at a disadvantage. He looks strong.
I could try talking to him.
Wait. Let me try.
All right, Laffy. Do what you need to.
Please, sir. May we have that? We need it badly.
Sorry, kid. I've only this one. You're so young. Do you really think you can make an Omega Elixir?
I have a friend who's very sick. If there's anything I can do to save him, anything at all, I have to try.
Did you already gather the other ingredients?
No, we still don't know what the last one might be. But I'll find it. I swear I will. My friend is suffering too much. I refuse to give up on him.
Take it.
Are you certain? Don't you need this as well?
I'm an exorcist. Talking to you, well, we're supposed to put the needs of others ahead of our own. You think not of yourself. I would be a poor model were I to deprive you in your time of need.
Thank you.
By the way, young one, perhaps this will help your cause. I've been studying an old book, and it would seem that the final ingredient is a Moloch's prayers. Unfortunately, thanks to the Lord of Calamity, the Abbey's been losing a good number of Molochim. I've managed to be exceedingly lucky and mine is still okay, but he will not give me his prayers, even when I command him to. Perhaps you will succeed. I have not faltered in my duties as an exorcist. The world must come before my family. I'm so sorry, Videl.
Now that we know what the last ingredient is, there's just one thing left to do.
Hey! I think that might have been Videl's dad.
Well, now that you mention it, Videl did say that his dad was an exorcist.
If he was the one who borrowed the book from Videl's mother, that would explain how he got here.
Damn, though, that's cold. Doesn't that mean he was willing to give up on his son? How could he place more value in the Abbey's teachings than on his own son's life?
I think he made the rational decision. Remember, he felt that there was no way he could get the last ingredient for himself, so...
Yeah, okay, sure, logic. Kids ain't logical. How do you think Videl would have taken this?
I'm sure he'd be terribly hurt.
Look at it like this. That guy clearly went to a lot of trouble to decipher the book. He would have faced considerable dangers just to get here.
Exorcists can't save the whole world. They have to live their lives conflicted like the rest of us. If everyone lived as selfishly as me, the world would be a wasteland.
Velvet.
I don't disagree, but he knew what he was doing.
Am I dreaming this? Is Velvet actually defending an exorcist? Pinch me!
I'm only stating the truth. Anyway, if we'd fought, it would have been to the death.
Good thing this ended peacefully.
Fee, I can't tell you what's right in this situation, but if Videl does die, the sadness will be numbing. I can promise you that.
Yeah, but I think even in sadness, hope can spring to life. As long as you keep living.
Anyway, we've got everything we need. Let's get back to Videl's house and make the Omega Elixir.
That exorcist said the last ingredient was a Moloch's prayers. That's all it is?
We're in good shape then. We've got Lafayette and Aizen and Bienfu. One of you can surely squeeze out a prayer or two, yeah?
Lafayette. I'm sorry, but Videl's already lost consciousness.
But he's still alive, isn't he? Please, let me see him. Videl, it's me, Lafayette. We have all of the ingredients for the Omega Elixir.
I'll prove that your translations were correct, Videl. Just wait.
Lafayette.
He's awake! No, he's just mumbling. That's all he's been saying this whole time.
I'm sorry. Sorry, Lafayette. I'm sorry I told you to go away. I really wanted to talk to you more.
It's fine, really. That doesn't matter now. You're my friend. There's so much of the world you still need to see. You have to get better so we can go on adventures together, okay? Huh? Is that...
It's the Omega Elixir. So it wasn't really a Moloch's prayers.
It was their tears.
Sweetheart, you're home!
I am. But I have no right to be here at this point. I chose to do my duty as an exorcist over the welfare of my own dear family. I won't ask for forgiveness. This isn't something that can be forgiven.
Dad?
Videl, are you feeling okay?
He's fine. A generous friend worked hard to prepare the Omega Elixir for him.
The Omega Elixir? Wait, don't tell me your friend is...
You helped him, right? I heard that it was you who told him what the final ingredient was. Thank you, Dad.
No, son. You have no idea. I...
Dad, it's okay. You protected the world in your own way. The one Mom and I live in. The one I want to explore when I get a little older.
Son...
All's well that ends well, hmm?
Hard to believe we managed to actually make an Omega Elixir. That's one hell of an accomplishment.
Oh, and here I was anticipating much wailing and gnashing of teeth. Videl turned out to be pretty resilient, huh?
Can't you just say good job like a normal person?
You're no fun. You did good, kid. Thanks. But I might have given up if not for Velvet's encouragement.
All I did was rile you up. I wouldn't call it encouragement.
Not you too, Velvet.
Anyway, that was a noble thing you did, Lafayette. You really held on to your hope all the way through.
Yeah. I just didn't want to give up on Videl. But I don't really think it's worth praising. I haven't felt lost like you have, Velvet. If I had, I don't think I would have been so sure of myself.
Perhaps. But I think you'll still have it in you. Even if you ever do lose something, dear.
Huh? Why?
That's just the feeling I get. Look, I'm tired of Eleanor's grumbling, so I thought I'd say something nice for once.
Could you not make this my fault?